You know, nearly three-quarters of the Major League Baseball owners are billionaires, and star players can make hundreds of millions of dollars. But it's a vastly different story in the minor leagues. Many players struggle just to make ends meet. But that's starting to change as more minor league players are speaking out, including Mission Viejo High School alum Karen Lovegrove. Our Jake Reiner now has that story.
It was really heartbreaking to see what guys were having to go through.
Karen Lovegrove doesn't just have a good baseball name. He plays the sport at a high level as a pitcher for the Rocket City Trash Pandas in Alabama, the AA affiliate of the Angels. He's also a Southern California native. He's speaking out because he says as a minor leaguer for 10 years, planning to retire at the end of this season, he's seen enough.
We were living two to each room. At one point, one of my catchers and I were sharing a queen bed because we weren't sure when we were going to be able to move in.
As it stands, MLB doesn't require its owners to cover the cost of housing for its minor leaguers, so it's up to Kieran and the rest of the thousands of professional players to foot the bill. Right now, Kieran lives in a three-bedroom apartment with five of his teammates, which is typical, he says. Privacy, not a perk of playing minor league baseball. However, living in Alabama pales in comparison to the cost of living in other parts of the country.
Say you're living in California, say you're living in New York, or places where rent is significantly higher, you'll live six or seven to a two-bed and have guys in the living room, guys in the kitchen.
There have been countless stories of players sleeping in cars, not being properly fed, and for some, an inability to support their families. Minor leaguers say the heart of the issue is that they aren't being paid enough to live comfortably. According to the nonprofit Advocates for Minor Leaguers, players on average make between $400 and $700 a week.
When you add that all up, we're talking $8,000, $10,000, you know, $12,000 a year. Very few minor league players are making more than $15,000 a year.
That money has to cover food, support family members, and pay rent. But that rent can double when players are called up and sent down to different levels of the minor leagues, often paying rent in multiple cities.
As far as I'm aware, there's no legal obligation for the team to cover any cost incurred by moving, despite the fact that it's the team choosing to move the player.
Advocates for Minor Leaguers has been ringing the alarm bell since it was founded last year. And in some cases, teams have made mid-season changes, like the Houston Astros. They agreed to cover the housing costs for all of its minor leaguers. The Dodgers, who declined to comment, have been at the forefront of nutrition.
The Dodgers with meals, they have a chef for all of their different minor league teams. And so, you know, they do a great job with meals. Having said that, they're not great with housing.
The Angels, who also declined to comment, have reportedly been one of the most egregious offenders. But just this week, first-year general manager Perry Manasian met with Lovegrove and his teammates in Alabama to hear their concerns.
This issue got addressed with the Angels, and they are now providing an extra meal. So you have three meals a day instead of two.
Unfortunately, the spectrum here between different major league teams is from bad to terrible is the truth.
Ultimately, what minor leaguers are asking for is a seat at the table to voice their concerns and for major league owners to listen and eventually implement changes.
For the MLB, it should be an opportunity to put out the absolute best product on the planet, to develop the best players with the best nutrition, the best sleep science, the best mental health, and really, really taking the time to see it as an opportunity for growing the game in a large scale.
Conditions in the minor leagues are just awful.